Hello, family. Today I want to share with you what Jesus tells his disciples during a season when he was about to depart from them. And that season was not a good season for the disciples. They thought Jesus was coming to stay and they take over political power and give them to be the guys in charge of Jerusalem and the world. But then they realized that Jesus was about to leave. And so Jesus, in such difficult times, he gives them something that is so critical in our lives today. And I can relate to our generation where we are living right now with the pandemic, with the economic recessions and businesses not doing well, layoffs. We also need something to anchor us that like the disciples needed. So John 15 verse 7 says, "If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done to you." Can you imagine what Jesus said? That whatever we desire, he will do it to us. If we only do two things, we abide in him and the word of God abides in us. What does that mean? It simply means that every day, find shelter in the Lord. Let Jesus cover you. Start your day in Jesus. Live your day with Jesus and let the covering of the Lord be upon your life. That is abiding in him, in his ways, in his doing. But secondly, he says, let his words abide in you. Let the word of God richly dwell in you. When the word of God saturates in your life, it changes your desires. It changes the way you see things. You cease seeing problems, you start seeing promises. Because the promise of the word of God is ever true. And so God says, if you abide in him and his word abides in you, whatever you desire, he will do it for you. And verse 9, he mentions another thing that we need to do. He says, as the Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. At the end of it all, let the love of God be your refuge. Let the love of God richly dwell in you. So when we do those three things, abiding in Jesus, abiding in his word, and in his love, whatever we desire, God will do it for us. God will answer your prayer.